السلام عليكم. We'll continue talking about the hemolytic anemia. Today we'll talk about sickle cell anemia. Sickle cell anemia. What the genetic problem is? Autosomal recessive. Autosomal recessive. It's okay. And what's the problem in this disease? It's okay. The problem is the mutation in beta chain in hemoglobin, beta chain in hemoglobin. So what happened if you have this chromosome and this beta globin gene? This problem in this gene, beta globin. So okay, and this chromosome is short arm chromosome 11. Chromosome 11, maybe this MSQ chromosome 11, and problem in the beta globin gene. What happened in this beta chain? Every chain has amino acid. This amino acid has contain glutamic acid. This amino acid is named glutamic acid. In this disease, what problem? This glutamic acid is replaced by another amino acid called valine. Called valine. So the problem here in the beta chain, what happened? Replacement of glutamic acid by amino acid is called valine. And this will cause this hemoglobin S. Hemoglobin S. As you know, the normal hemoglobin is hemoglobin A. But here you have is has hemoglobin S. It's okay. There is no type of sickle cell anemia. It's heterozygous and homozygous. So is homozygous and heterozygous. The homozygous is hemoglobin SS. This is a disease. This a disease. But this is called sickle cell triad. Called cell symbol disease. This is called heterozygous is sickle cell triad. So okay. So a child here in this homozygous has the two sickle gene from two parents. From you have his 1S and another S, 2S. So it's abnormal gene from one parent and another gene from the another parent. So his hemoglobin SS. But here is hemoglobin AS. So it has only one gene, normal and one abnormal gene. One abnormal gene. His one normal and one abnormal. But here two is abnormal. Hemoglobin SS. This is heterozygous and homozygous. So the disease, sickle cell disease, is homozygous. So okay, what's the character? So what's the character of the hemoglobin S? What's the character of hemoglobin S? Hemoglobin S is short lifespan. Short lifespan about 30 days only. About the 30 days. About hemoglobin, our hemoglobin is about 120 days. But here is hemoglobin is one short lifespan about 30 days. Also less soluble. Less soluble. Less negativity. All this may come in the MSQ. So less soluble, less negative. So okay. Less hemoglobin affinity to oxygen. So to catch the oxygen. So to ability of the hemoglobin to catch the oxygen. So it increase risk of desaturation. Because of desaturation. Then all this time, then the hemoglobin A. Less soluble, less negative, less hemoglobin affinity, and short life span, and less deformable. Less deformable. So if less deformable, is the destruction. So okay. all this character of the hemoglobin S. So short life span about 30 days, less affinity to oxygen, less soluble, less negative, and less deformable than hemoglobin S. What's the combination of this hemoglobin S? Maybe also this multiple chain. You have to this only just to know maybe question in the exam. It's contain two alpha like globin plus two beta like globins plus four heme molecule. So you have two alpha like globins and two beta like globins and four heme molecules, and this character of hemoglobin is, and we know this sickle cell has two types, is homozygous and heterozygous. There is another type of the sickle cell, not common, maybe rare type, yani it's called hemoglobin SC. What hemoglobin SC is? Sickle hemoglobin C, sickle hemoglobin C disease. And another one is hemoglobin SB plus. What's this? It's called sickle beta plus thalassemia. So okay, and also hemoglobin SB0, is sickle beta zero thalassemia. Not common, not care about it. Is this rare type, not common in the sickle cell. It's okay. Small note, maybe question in the also multiple choice is the heterozygous as this hemoglobin SA is this called triad, sickle cell triad is protect against falciparum, plasmodium falciparum. Yeah, for protection plasmodium falciparum. It's okay, but the homozygous, the disease is hemoglobin SS is high risk or severe to severe malaria complication. So okay, very very important, maybe the question in the exam. So the heterozygous, the triad is has protection from the malaria, but the homozygous, the disease has maybe severe complication and severe hemorrhosis from the malaria. So okay, the very important part of the sickle cell is sickle cell crisis. Every crisis you have to know, is this four crises you have to know, what's the complication of this crisis. What's the name of this crisis is thrombotic crisis. Thrombotic is this vaso-occlusive, it's okay, and hemolytic crisis, and sequestration crisis, and aplastic crisis. There is four crises for sickle cell you have to know. It's very, very important. This is importance of the sickle cell anemia. The first crisis is called vaso-occlusive or thrombotic. From the name is thrombus. What happened in this problem is painful because this thrombus painful. Anywhere, any thrombus in anywhere is painful. It's okay. What's the precipitation? What's the cause or precipitation of this thrombotic crisis? Is maybe infection, maybe dehydration. So okay, infection or dehydration, maybe acidosis, maybe stress. So okay, all this causes this crisis. So okay, so is thrombosis or this infection anywhere? This infection in anywhere? This thrombus or infection or thrombosis anywhere? Maybe in the brain, maybe cause stroke, and maybe in the liver, spleen, maybe in the bone. Very, very, very important. The bone. What causes in the bone? A vascular necrosis. Cause a vascular necrosis of the femur muscle, very, very common, of the hip. Vascular necrosis of the hip, very, very common. And another thing, very, very important, is spleen. What causes in the spleen? Hypospadenism. Because spleen has multiple infarctions, so spleenism, hypospadenism, called autospleenectomy. So hypospadenism or called auto splenectomy as you remove the spleen, because this multiple thrombi, multiple thrombi, multiple thrombi will cause necrosis and necrosis or death of this spleen level, the spleen cells called autospleenism or hypospleenism. Very, very common. And it's called also functional hypospleenism. And also maybe this infarction may be in the penis. And they called periapism. And this periapism, this blood go inside and do not go outside. So okay. So this the main problem here is vaso-occlusive. Vaso-occlusive or thrombotic. Thrombosis in anywhere. In the brain, liver, spleen. But in the commonest and the common scenario in the exam. In the bone cause a vascular necrosis of the hip, very common, and the spleen cause autospleenism or functional splenectomy or hypospleenism, and the penis can cause periapism. And also in the this patient has high precipitation to has disease osteomyelitis. Very, very important also question. The osteomyelitis common here, common also in the this patient, osteomyelitis. And what the causes of this, what the bacteria cause of the osteomyelitis is Salmonella. So if you find in the exam patient have osteomyelitis and has history of the sickle cell, remember of Salmonella or so patient has osteomyelitis, the problem is the cause is Salmonella, common in the patient of sickle cell anemia. So okay, Salmonella, osteomyelitis, common in the sickle cell anemia. So there was the question in this area is spleen can cause osteosplenectomy, functional osteosplenectomy or hyosplenectomy. El bone, a vascular necrosis, common question. And another question is Salmonella osteomyelitis, common in the patient of the osteomyelitis. This is very, very important. First crisis is thrombotic crisis or vaso-occlusive crisis. Another small crisis is called sequestration crisis. Sequestration crisis. What sequestration crisis? Is sickling in the organ as spleen. He sickling in the organ as spleen or liver. What happened? Causing pooling of blood. And pooling of the blood can cause anemia. So liver or spleen, what takes the blood? Pooling of the blood. Pooling of the blood, collection of the blood, pooling in the blood, and will cause anemia of the disease. So it's pooling of the blood inside the organ as liver is being because sickling in the liver is being. What disease related to this crisis is called acute chest syndrome. Acute chest syndrome, what's the patient complain? Complain of fever. Acute chest syndrome can cause complain of fever, chest pain, shortness of breath. So, okay. And all what also, and low BO2. So, cool. Can low. So, okay. And the X-ray can cause, and chest X-ray can cause infiltrate. This acute chest syndrome. So okay, and this acute chest syndrome, the most common cause of this in adult patient in sickle cell. The common cause of this can cause this. It can maybe the question here. What's the common cause this of the sickle cell? Maybe this disease acute chest syndrome. But in the children, if you have patient sickle cell patient child. The common cause maybe infarction or infection. So, okay. So, acute chest syndrome, as we know, fever, shortness of breath, chest pain, and low oxygen and infiltrate, and maybe cause this. So, what's the cause of this in the child? Maybe infarction. And this infarction in the neuro, yani CVS, CNS. Maybe CNS or CVS, common in CVS, infarction or infection. And we'll know what type of infection is the patient of the sickle cell. But child, the most common cause of child is infection or infarction. So, okay. Another thing. 5 to 10% of the sickle patient, 5 to 10% of the sickle patient may have stroke. May have stroke in the childhood. Childhood. And this only one indication of exchange transfusion. Very, very important. So, about 5 to 10% of the patient in childhood may have a stroke in the brain. So, it's the only indication for exchange transfusion. Very, very, very important. Not give anything in this stroke. Not give antithrombotic or hydroxyurea or anything bone marrow transplantation. But very, very important question is exchange transfusion. So, we'll finish this crisis is sequestration. What's sequestration? Sickling in the organ as brain or liver can cause pooling of the blood. And this pooling of the blood can cause anemia. So, okay? And we are talking about a syndrome. It's called acute chest syndrome. The patient complains of fever, chest pain, chest oppressed, low blood pressure, low BO2, and infiltrate in the X-ray. And can cause the common cause this in the adult. Sickle cell adult is acute chest syndrome. But in the children, one of the common cause of this is infarction, maybe in the CVS or infection. Pneumococcal, meningococcal, we will take. So okay, an infection and infarction. And small note, NB very, very important, not forget, the patient may have stroke in childhood. 10% of the patient has stroke in the childhood. So okay, neurological stroke. So what the treatment is exchange transfusion. So now we finish two crises is sequestration crisis and vaso-occlusive crisis. Now we'll take the third crisis is aplastic crisis. Aplastic crisis, what's the cause of this aplastic crisis is parvovirus B19. Parvovirus B19 is the cause of this aplastic crisis. Senescence of the erythro basis. So this virus will affect progenitor of RBCs in bone marrow. So there's no erythro basis. There's no senescence of the RBCs. What happened? It happened cause sudden drop. If you find in the scenario sudden drop of hemoglobin. Some drop of hemoglobin in the CBC report. So okay, it's a very, very important sudden drop. So okay, and this is self-limited, about 10, from 7 to 10 days will stop this hemorrhosis. So this aplastic crisis is parvovirus B19 is very important, can cause sudden drop of the hemoglobin with increase of reticulocytosis, sudden drop of the drop of hemoglobin with reticulocytosis. Last one, last crisis is rare crisis, not common, is called hemolytic crisis. Hemolytic is caused from hemolysis. This hemolysis, and this will decrease L hemoglobin level. This hemolytic crisis will decrease of the hemoglobin causes hemolysis. It's okay. The anemia of sickle cell is symptomatic at about level of 7. Hemoglobin 7, this become symptomatic. Hemoglobin 7, this become symptomatic in the sickle cell anemia. It's okay. We are now finish our crises in the sickle cell. They are very important. Is vaso-occlusive and sequestration crisis and aplastic crisis and hemolytic crisis. How to diagnose the sickle cell anemia? Diagnosis, the problem is in hemoglobin. So we are doing hemoglobin electrophoresis. What he found in the hemoglobin electrophoresis is hemoglobin S. This very, very important diagnostic test is hemoglobin electrophoresis, because the problem in the hemoglobin, we are use hemoglobin S. Use hemoglobin electrophoresis, you find hemoglobin S. A lot old test not used now called sickle dex test not used because not accurate, not accurate, not used. What problem? Added reagent to blood and will cause turbidity. So it has hemoglobin, hemoglobin S, but is not accurate. So our investigation is hemoglobin electrophoresis. Any hemoglobin problem, you are using hemoglobin electrophoresis. So showing hemoglobin S is very important. So what's the treatment of this hemolytic type of hemolytic anemia, sickle cell anemia? First thing is, as usual, is symptomatic treatment. If you have pain, you have from this thrombus, you have give analgesic. If you have infection, we give antibiotic. If you have dehydration, you can give rehydration, good rehydration, because dehydration one of the causes of the crisis. So good rehydration and treatment of infection, pain, analgesic. If you have anemia, we give blood transfusion. Blood transfusion, the aim of the hemoglobin from 11 to 12, from 10 to 11. The aim of the hemoglobin from 11 to 10 to 11, our target of hemoglobin. And not forget, one of complication we informed this neurological stroke. We doing what we can do is exchange transfusion, as we informed before. The only one used here, exchange transfusion, if the patient has a neurological problem, is neurological stroke from the sickle cell. If a patient have sickle cell and have stroke, we can give exchange transfusion. Exchange transfusion, very, very important. Neurological complication of the sickle cell, we give exchange transfusion. Some note, very, very important. If the patient has anemia, avoid, not give iron therapy. The patient of sickle cell, not give iron therapy, very, very important, because this iron can increase the iron overload, cause iron overload. Very, very important, not give iron in the case of sickle cell, can cause iron overload. And another thing, not give intra-articular steroid. The theory is not clear, or not, no one knows the cause. However, it's not give intra-articular steroid in the patient of sickle cell, because can associated with a sickle cell crisis. The cause not clear, no one know why, but is documented this. If you give intra-articular steroid, is not given in the patient of the sickle cell. Not forget this. And not forget, so now we give treatment symptomatic and exchange transfusion in the case of the neurological complication of the sickle cell. Not forget the main problem also, we are taking this hypoisbonism. Any patient have hypoisbonism or splenectomy or otosplenectomy, as this case, or hypoisbonism or otosplenectomy, need vaccination. What's the vaccination? Anyone have removed the spleen, or as in case, this case, multiple infarction in the spleen can cause necrosis of the spleen. What's the vaccination? First thing is influenza vaccine. First vaccine is taken every year, take influenza vaccine. And also pneumococcal vaccine every 5 years. So we are giving influenza vaccine every year and pneumococcal every 5 years. And Haemophilus influenza type B, if not given before, can give also Haemophilus influenza type B, and meningococcal C vaccine if not taken. Meningococcal C vaccine. So we'll give influenza vaccine, pneumococcal vaccine, meningococcal vaccine, C vaccine, and influenza, Haemophilus influenza type B. And we informed before, what's the organism, most common organism the patient have nosebleed or hypoisbonectomy, the most common bacteria we are fear from is encapsulated bacteria. An encapsulated بكتيريا. What encapsulate bacteria as اللي هو as strep pneumoniae and hemophilus influenza and meningococcal meningitis or Neisseria meningococcal. So very very important. Strep pneumoniae very very important and hemophilus influenza and Neisseria meningococci. خلاص strep pneumoniae and hemophilus influenza and Neisseria meningococci is very very important to take care this mostly common bacteria. This encapsulated bacteria in a patient has nosebleed or otosplenectomy or hypoxemia as our case. So okay. Also if the patient can give, this patient can give prophylaxis. Also patient of sickle cell can give prophylaxis, as we told this vaccination can be taken or can give prophylaxis. As we told this inhibition homozygous, the homozygous this disease, homozygous is mostly can cause exposure to malaria and with severe complication with the malaria, so can give malaria prophylaxis. Malaria prophylaxis in the if the patient travel to endemic area or the patient in endemic area can give malaria malaria vaccination or malaria prophylaxis if travel to endemic area. And also homozygous can give lifelong penicillin. Lifelong penicillin. Also, some say give lifelong penicillin. In the patient of the homozygous sickle disease, can give lifelong penicillin with vaccination we are take. With vaccination we take, can take also with vaccination can give lifelong penicillin. In some cases of the homozygous sickle cell, can give penicillin with vaccination we take and prophylaxis taken for malaria. So okay. Another last thing we are take something called hydroxyurea. Hydroxyurea. What's hydroxyurea and what this use and side effect? Hydroxyurea. What the action is inhibit ribonucleotide reductase. Inhibit ribonucleotide reductase. Ribonucleotide reductase. What's this ribonucleotide reductase? So inhibit purine and pyridine synthesis. So inhibit purine and pyrimidine synthesis. What's this? What's the importance of this hydroxyurea? If you not remember this, very very important to increase hemoglobin F. To replace, يعني he wanted to replace the hemoglobin S, because hemoglobin S, as we told, is what's the problem you can do. So is increase hemoglobin F. What's the action? Inhibit ribonucleotide reductase. So inhibit purine and pyrimidine synthesis. But what's the importance to remember in the exam is decrease hemoglobin, increase hemoglobin F, increase hemoglobin F. So this protect against the sickling. What's the action of this hemoglobin F? Protect against sickling. Protect against sickling. What's this? Hemoglobin F. Hemoglobin F. So, as we talked before, this hydroxyurea can be used in the acute chest syndrome. So, acute chest syndrome can use treatment is hydroxyurea. What's the acute chest syndrome? The patient of sickle cell can complain of fever, chest pain, shorts of breath, low BO2, and infertility of the lung. This acute chest syndrome can mean cause this. And the acute chest syndrome is the most common cause of the death in the adult, acute chest syndrome. What's the treatment of the acute chest syndrome is hydroxyurea. Hydroxyurea is the treatment of acute chest syndrome. And what's the action, what's the importance of the hydroxyurea is increase hemoglobin F. What's the importance of this hemoglobin F is protect against the sickling. I want to decrease hemoglobin S and give increase the hemoglobin F. What's the importance of hemoglobin F? Decrease the sickling in the cells. But what's the action? Question here, what's the side effect of the hydroxyurea is myelosuppression. Suppression of the bone marrow, very, very important. Myelosuppression. It's called severe myelosuppression also. Severe myelosuppression. So hydroxyurea, what's side effect? Severe myelosuppression. Last thing to complete our talking about the sickle cell is screening. If you want to do screening before the delivery of the baby. If you want screening for sickle cell, first thing we are doing for the pregnant woman. If the first thing is pregnant woman, if the carrier, if the female is carrier, خلاص it's okay. If normal, it's okay. Normal, خلاص it's okay. Nothing. If she carrier, we are doing to his husband, to her husband, doing husband, the father, doing for father. If the negative, it's okay. If positive, so is the he carrier and the carrier, so we are doing it for the baby. We're doing the baby in here, baby. We are doing take sample from the chronic villus. Take sample from chorionic villus or the amniocentesis from amniotic fluid, amniocentesis. But first, we are doing for mother. If the mother pregnancy is mother is carrier, we're doing to her father. If negative, it's okay. If the carrier, we are doing to father. If the father is carrier positive, we can doing for baby and chronic villus and amniocentesis for screening if this patient or this baby will has the sickle cell or not has sickle cell. All this our talking today about the sickle cell anemia. What the sickle cell anemia is hemoglobin S. The key is hemoglobin S. And what is the replacement problem in the beta chain in chromosome 11. Replacement of the glutamic acid by valine. What the importance of this hemoglobin S, what the problem in hemoglobin S is less soluble, less deformable, short life span, and less negativity. All this we are talk today. And what's the importance of this sickle cell is crisis. The very important is about the exclusive crisis and sequestration crisis and the hemolytic crisis and the aplastic crisis. The vaso-occlusive crisis is very, very important in thrombosis. Why? Thrombosis and very, very important two sites, very important spleen cause hypospadenism or auto splenectomy. And in the bone, not forget the avascular necrosis of the hip. And also not forget osteomyelitis caused by salmonella, common in the sickle cell anemia. And also we finish and aplastic anemia caused by parvovirus B12. What's happened? Sudden drop of the hemoglobin. And another one is hemolytic, not common, this drop in hemoglobin. And about symptomatic about anemia, about hemoglobin 7. And we talk aplastic and hemolytic and vaso-occlusive. Another one is sequestration crisis, is pooling of the blood if the anemia, and not forget the acute chest syndrome, and this is most common cause of this in this case, and the most common cause of the in child is infection or infection. Not forget we are taking the problem in the neurological complication of the sickle cell, we are give exchange transfusion, and all the treatment is symptomatic. And not forget the our diagnosis is a problem in the hemoglobin, so I give hemoglobin electrophoresis will showing hemoglobin S. And don't forget the hypospadenism or autosplenectomy, we are give vaccination. Not vaccination, what's the important vaccination for encapsulated bacteria is strep pneumonia and hemophilus influenza and Neisseria meningococcus. And we are give vaccination is hemophilus influenza for every year and pneumococcal every 5 years. I think all this talking today will complete our talking today about sickle cell. We are finished talking about the hemolytic anemia and waiting for another lesson for complete our traveling in the blood. Thank you and see you soon.